Hello. In today's video, we shall learn in detail about fungus penicillium. By the end of this video, you'll have a clear understanding about the characteristics of penicillium, its mode of reproduction, both asexual and sexual, and also its life cycle. Let us start with the introduction to fungus penicillium. Penicillium, a type of fungus belonging to phylum Ascomycota. It is commonly known as the green or blue mold. It grows as a saprophyte feeding on dead and decaying organisms. Alexander Fleming was able to successfully isolate antibiotic penicillin from Penicillium chrysogenum in 1929. Penicillium is used in the production of different types of cheese, various organic acids like citric acid, tartaric acid, some enzymes like amylase, cellulase, pectinase, etc. It is also helpful in the production of antifungal drugs. Penicillium plays an important role as a decomposer in the ecosystem. Now, let us learn about the characteristics of penicillium. The vegetative structure of penicillium is a multicellular mycelium. It is composed of colorless, slender, tubular, highly branched multinucleate septate structures known as hyphae. The cell wall of penicillium is made up of glucose polysaccharide and chitin. The cells are short and the septa between the cells have a central pore. The cell relies on this central pore to maintain cytoplasmic continuity or connections. The hyphae get intertwined with one another. Some hyphae grow deeper into the substratum to absorb food material. Other hyphae that rest on the surface produce reproductive structures. The cells of the hyphae contain nucleus, granular cytoplasm, and food particles. Embedded in the cytoplasm are present mitochondria, endoplasmic reticulum, ribosomes, etc. Oil granules are present as reserve food. Penicillium reproduces asexually by conidiospores, which are produced exogenously. Sexual reproduction is by the formation of ascospores. By the way, if you're getting some value out of this video, please like and share the video so that all of us can learn, unlearn, and relearn together. Also, please consider subscribing the channel and press the bell icon to get instant notification of all the upcoming videos. Now, let us learn about reproduction in penicillium. The different modes of reproduction seen in penicillium are vegetative reproduction by fragmentation. The hyphae breaks up accidentally into several fragments and each fragment by repeated divisions grows into a mycelium. Asexual reproduction is by conidia. It is dominant and is the main mode of reproduction. And finally, the sexual reproduction. Let us understand the process involved in asexual reproduction. It is by sporulation. At the tip of long, erect septate hyphae, called the conidiophores, non-motile asexual spores called conidia are formed exogenously. The conidiophores are hyaline, smooth, or rough-walled. They branch several times to form primary, secondary, and tertiary branches. The branches which bear flower-shaped structures, stigmata, or the phyllites, are known as metulate. Chains of single-celled conidia are produced in basipetal succession, with the youngest one at the base. The apical portion of the conidiophore with metulae, stigmata, and chains of conidia give a brush-like appearance and is known as penicillus. Formation of conidia. The conidia are formed at the tip of the stigmata. First, the tip swells, the nucleus divides into two, one of them migrate into the swollen tip. A septum develops and a uninucleate cell is formed. The protoplast of this cell develops into a conidium. The process is repeated several times, resulting in the formation of a long chain of conidia in basipetal succession. The conidia may be of various shapes, like ovoid, elliptical or piriform, and it may be smooth or rough. They are easily disseminated by the wind and is a quick means of propagation. Germination of conidia. When the conidia falls on a suitable substratum under suitable condition, it swells and gives rise to a germ tube. The nucleus of the conidium divides mitotically multiple times, and the nuclei so formed remain in the germ tube. The germ tube elongates, becomes septate. On further elongation and septa formation, it gives rise to a mature branched mycelium. Next, let us understand the process of sexual reproduction in penicillium. Penicillium may be homothallic. Both Antheridia and Archegonia are born on the same mycelium, or it may be heterothallic. Both male and female sex organs are born on different thallus. The female sex organs are known as Ascogonia, and the male sex organs are known as Antheridia respectively. One of the cells of the vegetative mycelium develops into Ascogonium. The mature Ascogonium is long, erect, multinucleate tubular structure. Its upper end is curved. When young, Ascogonium is uninucleate. As it elongates, the single nucleus divides repeatedly to form 32 to 64 nuclei. Antheridia, a slender uninucleate hyphal branch, coils around the Archegonium several times. The apical part becomes inflated and is separated by a septum to form Antheridium, which is short, club-shaped and uninucleate structure. Plasmogamy, the tip of the mature Antheridium comes in contact with the Ascogonium. The intervening walls dissolve and the two protoplasts come in contact. Plasmogamy thus takes place by gametangial contact. One male nucleus and one female nucleus form a pair and is called a dikaryon. Here, the haplophase ends and the dikaryophase starts. There are several post-plasmogamy changes seen in penicillium. Septa formation in Ascogonium results in each segment having a pair of nuclei. From the middle segments arise the ascogenous hyphae. The last dikaryotic cell enlarges and functions as Ascus mother cell. The two nuclei in it fuse, and this is known as karyogamy. With this, the dikaryophase ends. The cell containing the fusion nucleus, synkaryon, is known as the ascus. The young ascus with the diploid nucleus represents the transitory diplophase. The diploid nucleus undergoes meiosis and mitosis to form 8 haploid nuclei. Each nucleus is surrounded by a mass of cytoplasm. The uninucleate protoplast develops walls and forms ascospores. It is surrounded by interwoven sterile hyphae called the peridium. The septate ascogonium, ascogenous hyphae, ascospores, peridium together are known as ascocarp. The mature ascocarp of penicillium is a round, closed, thick structure known as cleistothecium. At maturity, the ascus wall dissolves, the outer hard surface of cleistothecium breaks or disintegrates, and the ascospores are liberated. Let us summarize the life cycle of penicillium with the help of a flowchart. Haplophase is represented by the saprophytic mycelium. It undergoes asexual reproduction with the help of non-motile spores called conidia. The haplomycelium also produces the antheridium with male nucleus and archegonium with female nucleus. Pairing of nuclei results in dikaryon. The haplophase ends and the dikaryophase starts. Ascogonium with paired nuclei, ascogenous hyphae, ascus mother cell represents the dikaryophase. Karyogamy takes place in the ascus mother cell and dikaryophase ends. The young ascus with diploid nucleus represents the transitory diplophase. Meiotic division in the ascus results in haploid ascospores. Each ascospore, on reaching a suitable substratum, gives rise to a haplomycelium. So today, we have learnt in detail about the characteristics of penicillium, its mode of reproduction, both asexual and sexual, and also its life cycle comprising of the haplophase, the dikaryophase, and the transitory diplophase. I have some practice questions for you. Please share your answers in the comment section below. You can pause the video and write down the questions if you like. Thank you so much for your time and participation. If you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please consider subscribing the channel and press the bell icon to get instant notification of all the upcoming videos. Also, if you want to discuss any particular topic in biology, please mention that in the comments section below. I'll see you there. Goodbye. All the best.